Hey, Perry Peacock here with Wilderness Innovation, and I'm out here in the middle of this juniper forest, mostly juniper with some areas pretty thick with oak brush, or you know, we have a lot of that in this area in Utah. But I wanted to show some ideas of how you can pitch up your poncho as a hammock when you're in areas like this. So if we look back right in here, I've chosen a couple of small junipers, maybe about 12 or so feet tall. Most of the juniper in this area is not that large. A little farther south from us, there's some pretty good size ones, but I just want to show you what you can do with a couple small junipers like these. And they're about, I'm estimating about 12 feet apart, trunk to trunk here. Now you notice there's quite a bit of growth down in here between the trees. And I'll show you, it's very quick with just a little bit of pruning, while you can clean up the middle a little bit and easily make room for poncho to be set up as a hammock. Well, there's a couple of ways to attack this sort of stuff in here. Sometimes we're into these trees where, you know, it's a lot of dead stuff down here, but in here we're a little more alive. So I just make a few cuts here, a little bit of pruning. And we'll be good to go. A lot of times I'll chop this kind of stuff out with a little hatchet or something, but this is kind of a thick growth right here, so it'd be hazardous to try to get a good enough trim out of it. So what I want to do is just kind of clean up the middle here. So I want to give myself room to put my hammock in between here. Let me just clean this up and I'll do a little more trimming. Alright, so now you can see I've cleaned out about a dozen small limbs. Most of them, you know, a couple fingers diameter or less. And so just a little bit of quick cleanup. I've got my space ready here. You can see I've got a tarp or a poncho here. This is a poncho in Marpat pattern. So I'll show you how you, I think I might make a new video showing how to how to set up the whole little hammock setup with our poncho, because it's one we got, it's pretty old. Now, so what I do is I undo my hank, find the middle point right here, and then I usually carry in my wallet a little Swiss Army knife, a little small one like that, and I've put about a 1-inch split ring, key ring, on here. So what I do, all we need is a little help from gravity, so I just go like that. So I tuck my loop of my parachute cord through there. Then I just bring the knife up through there. Now that hanging there, that's enough weight to pull this thing down through here. Of course, if you have something bigger, it'll drop faster, you know. It's just whatever, but and then I usually just hold my cord above here and then just shake it with the other hand and get it on down there. Sometimes it'll hang up right here where this center tarp tab is, and so you might have to just slide it aside of there, but it's almost all the way through, so it skipped right by there. So here we are. It came out the end. So you see it came out the end right there. So now it's very simple. Just pull your parachute cord off up your knife in your pocket, you're good to go. And now we just take this loop right here, we pass the other two free ends, but everything is now, I'll step back a little here, everything is now all inside of there. So now we're just taking up the slack, and I try to get this where the loop and everything goes through. I try to get that somewhere about in the middle. So that's one end done, and I'll do the other one, and we'll get ready to hang this in the, bring these two trees here. All right, so now I've got my parachute cord through the two cord sleeves on each end of my poncho so that I can turn it into a hammock. And what I usually like to do, just to kind of get a feel for it, is I usually like to lay it on the ground between my two trees, and I see how much distance I've got between each one. So I just try to do that so I can judge when I, especially when I string up one side. So I try to space, you know, about that far off the tree, and then we're good to go on that. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I just trimmed out a minimal amount of branches. I could have taken this one right here out too, but you know, I'm good. I'm going to go through here like this. I'll show you how I pitch these. Now, I'm pitching a little bit higher than waist high right here, and that's pretty common for the way we pitch them. And when I laid my poncho on the ground, or my hammock, to see how far out, I was about an arm's length here, fist to elbow. I'm going to go a little bit closer than that because we get a little bit of stretch in the cord and in the poncho. Okay, so here's the way I do it, which takes some of the stress off your knots and stuff like that. So I just went around, and I'm going to cross over or cross under. I'm going to go back around through the same way I came. So I'm out here like this. And then sometimes I go back a couple times just to take up extra cord. Doesn't really matter. I like to do it at least one time though. And then I just pull through the middle here to start myself up a couple half hitches. And then that right there is the way it's done. Now we'll do the other side. The other side's the one where we're going to determine a little more our tensioning and everything. Alright, so now I've got this side pitched up, that side's done up. Usually the first thing I'll do is I'll gather the material a little bit, and I'll just kind of push down a little bit and kind of tighten everything up and see. If my hood is dragging on the ground, you know, just doing this, then I'll tension up a little bit more. So I'm gonna tension up this side just a little bit more. I used to pitch these poncho. I still call it a poncho, even though we're using it as a hammock here. But I'm gonna pull just a little more, not much, just a little more out of it. I used to pitch these pretty high, and I found I like to pitch them a little lower to the ground normally, because it's easier to get in and out of them, you know. And I used to pitch them a lot tighter than I do now. There we go. Okay, so now there we go. Now we're in good shape. Now here's what we do. Everybody wonders, what about that hood? Well, what I like to do is, you'll notice there's a snap in the hood and a snap on the chest of your poncho, and that's to be able to close over the head hole. Once you do that, you just pull your hood drawstring up snug, and there you go. Now, one thing you'll find when you're when you're in a hammock is everything in your pockets will wind up out of your pockets. So oftentimes I'll just take my everything in my pockets and I dump them into the hood and make sure you don't want to, I mean, these things are pretty tough, but you know, by the same token, you don't want to, you know, have something really sharp that's sticking out, you know. And typically we also don't want to get into, and since that knife is, that Mora knife is short enough in relative to the hood that it goes clear down in there, it's not going to be any impact at all. So now I'm pretty good. Now one thing that I like to do, see, this is a long poncho. So you see there's more distance from the hood to that end than from the hood to this end, because on the poncho there's, remember, this is a long version, PSSL, so it's a foot longer in the back. So what I usually like to do is when I'm using a long, I'm 5'10", I can use either size, the regular or the long. But if I'm using a long, I usually like to put my head that way so my rear end is about right here and not right over the head hole. Which actually, you'll really never find that's a problem anyway. but I don't know, it's just one of my little preferences. And one thing you don't want to do with your feet is you don't want to be pushing a lot of pressure in here when you're trying to adjust. I'm going to go ahead and get in with my shoes on, but I'll be more careful. So anyway, you know, I just typically get in here like this, try to get positioned about halfway, and lay back into here. And now I'm good and cozy in my poncho I've set up as a hammock between two actually fairly small juniper trees, and as you can see they hold me up very nicely, no problem whatsoever. So you know, these ponchos work very nicely as a hammock, and you know, a lot of times we like to sit around like this, and if I'm out and doing some research or whatever, if I have my iPad, I'll sit here and type notes in there or write in a notepad or something, or sometimes I'll do some reading. So it's real comfortable to sit like this in there or when you're eating breakfast or your meals. So, you know, it's a very, very nice. And here's actually, for me, this is how I like the height to be. So you see, when I'm sitting like this, my feet are just touching the ground. And to me that's the perfect, you know, that's the perfect height. It works really nice. It's easy in, easy out. And you notice all my stuff in my pockets is down here out of the way. Now, a lot of people like to get in their hammock like this. And you know, that works well too, you know, whatever you want. I mean, now these things are pretty tough, but you know, of course they're not indestructible. So you do want to have some cautions. I've tried to trim away any, sometimes especially in junipers, you can get some really sharp, very stout, dead branches sticking out. So I've made sure that even when this thing's swinging, I've cleared that sort of stuff out of here. So I'm good to go, and I think I got a little bit of daylight left. I think I'm going to go ahead and pitch a tarp over here and a scorpion setup, just to show you what else we can do inside the juniper forest, setting up our poncho. Okay, so now I've got the regular size tarp, the PST, which is 7 feet by 7 feet square. And I like to, when I'm using with a hammock, I like to pitch it on the diagonal. Because as you know from your math, a 7 by 7 square comes out to about 10 feet on the diagonal. So my poncho set up as a hammock is 8 feet long. So I have more than enough length to cover the end of my hammock with the tarp. So you don't have to have a large tarp. You know, a lot of people think I got to have a large one in order to, because 7 feet won't cover a 7 or 8 foot hammock, you know. But when you pitch it on the diagonal, it works pretty nice, works very well. So let me show you that little setup, and I'm going to have to hurry a little bit before it gets too dim here. Once the sun goes over the mountain over there, it gets dark in a hurry, so let me hurry and get this thing set up for you. Okay, now on this tarp, I got about 18 tabs sewn in there on the corners and all around the edges, and two in the middle. Now, anytime you get a tarp from us, it comes with three of these shock cords, three different lengths. This is the short one, and there's a lot of things I can do with this. Like, for example, I can just go around these two branches right here, and I can shove the loop of the bungee cord in there. I can pull my other end through. And then it's got a cord lock on there, so I can, if I need to tighten it up and adjust it, I can. But now what this does is gives me a little bit of shock absorbing on this end, and I can tie the other side over there off with regular cord and no problem. I mean, I could do them both with cord, but a lot of times when you're going between two trees, and if you're trying to snug something up, it's nice to have one side, you know, have a little bungee on it. All right, now I've got this cord left over from setting my hammock up, and I've already tested it, and I know that, you know, I don't need to adjust it anymore. So this cord here is just hanging here, useless. So I oftentimes like to take advantage of that, and I'll just, since I'm close right here, I'll just go around the tree like that, and I'll just come back here on this, it's a little branch back here, and I'll just throw a couple of half hitches on there. And that'll be good enough. You see, because I've got the shock cord on the other side, you know, I've got a little bit of tension here, a little bit of wiggle room. Okay, so what I've done here is a little piece of this juniper that I trimmed out of here to clear the way for my little shelter setup. I just sharpened the tip with my backpacks, Gerber backpacks, little short handle deal. And you notice I left it long, and just run that up there a little bit, and then then I can work it in the ground good enough here with my hand by leaving it long. Typically, a lot of the area around junipers, the soil can be a little softer than you'd find probably most other places. All right, so here's the back edge of my tarp, and you notice my hammock was marpat camo. This is woodland, we call it woodland TBO because it's got a tan blackout coating inside, which keeps any light from passing through. And being tan, it also, if you're using a night light or something like that inside of there, it reflects well off that tan and really brightens up the inside of your shelter. So anyway, so there's the back out of the way. Now let me dress out the front and show you what we're doing there. All right, so this is one of the branches we pruned out of here, and we're gonna make some good use of it. I've trimmed off pretty much all the little stubs and everything sticking out. You notice I left a couple up here. whenever I'm doing the, we call this the stingray setup, and whenever we do this, I typically like to leave a couple on where I can hang, you know, hang my hat, hang a jacket or something like that, so you can have stuff up off the ground. Now we do have our tarps come with a tent stake bag that's got Velcro on the bottom part of it, so you can slide it over the end of a stick, and then you can, and then it sticks to the Velcro that's on the underside of the tarp. A regular tarp has two of these locations, one in the center, one halfway to one corner. So since I've set this up diagonally, I'm going to use this one diagonal to the corner, and I'm going to fasten that, put the bag over the end of the stick, and then stick that to there, and then we'll be all set up. Stake out the front corner, and be good to go. Okay, so I'm going to go about right there. Pound that in. The ground out here a little bit away from that, under those junipers, is a little bit harder here, but no big deal. We'll do us a taut line here. We don't need a lot of tension on this little tarp between these two trees, so that'll work just fine. And I'll leave it slippery. So there we are. I'll give you a view here of the shelter. Okay, so we're staked off here. We've got our little pole in here, which makes what we call the stingray setup. So now inside of here, I have a little bit of room to maneuver around and everything. And as you can see, I'm get kind of a view up in here. So you can see I'm nicely sheltered up inside of here. And I'm going to do one more thing. See that black line? That's the piece of Velcro in the center. I'm going to run one more kind of a ridge line, a top line, so it pulls that back up just a little bit. And then this shelter will be done and ready to use. Alright, so you see there's my center tie-off point. And you notice I've tied off to this little small branch up here, just not much more than finger size. And then I've gone, and you'll notice I'm off center back towards the back. So I'm pulling up and I'm pulling back. And I did the same thing over on the other side. I tied off back there. So that gives me an up and back pull, which helps to give me a little bit more room on the back. And I'm pretty much shielded from this back is the, this is the, it's fa- this is facing the way storms typically come into here. So if a storm's blowing in here, I'm kind of low on the back side, so I'm well protected on the back. Sometimes you're going to do a setup like this, and all you want, it's in the summertime, and all you want is, you know, shade from the sun. Well, you know, you can do that. Sometimes you don't need to worry about rain. Sometimes it might be wind. Sometimes it's just getting in the shade, you know, or that sort of thing. So let me go get in the hammock on the other side and just kind of show you what it's like inside of there. Okay, so now you'll see I've pulled that centerpiece up there probably about at least a foot or 14 inches or so, and I've pulled a little bit back that way on it by the way I tied that off. Now there's a gazillion ways you can set up the tarp over here, and this is basically the most simple, the easiest to do. And I could, depending on my needs, I could set up the back side, stake it farther out to give me a little more, you know, room in the back. But for a basic little setup, this is really nice. All right, so now we get down into here, and I'm not going to lay all the way in here because you won't be able to see me. So anyway, So here I am. I'm up inside of here. I'm well covered on the ends. I'm well covered on my backside. And this little, and I love this little vestibule area right here that this scorpion setup gives us. It makes it, you know, it makes it possible to, you know, have a little bit of dry area where you can put some of your goods in here. And you see, I did hang my hat up on one of those two little prongs up there. And, you know, this does really well. Sometimes, depending on the weather, sometimes I've taken some bank line and pulled out on a couple of these to even kind of broaden it out a little bit more. But as you can see, our standard PST, the 7x7, works very nicely on a, this is a long poncho set up as a hammock. So I'm 8 feet long here as a hammock, and it fits inside of here very, very nicely. I've got, you know, I got some room on each end that goes beyond the end of my hammock. So this works really nicely. Now of course, if I'm leaning back like this, see, I would want to stake out my backside a little bit farther out that way. But here again, like I say, you can set these up so many different ways. That's what we love about having just enough on here, just enough tabs, just enough of everything to allow you a whole bunch of different ways to set things up, but not too many things that restrict you to have to do things a certain way. So, you know, this gives you a nice little setup here. Everything's sturdy enough, I can bounce, whatever, you know. I'm having a great time. I love it outdoors. I'm about 15 minutes from the shop here in the foothills of the mountains. Loving the day, beautiful day. A lot warm for February. It's very, very warm, and no snow for February. This is going to be a rough summer if we don't get some more snow. But anyway, Perry Peacock, Wilderness Innovation, loving the outdoors. Take care. I'll see you on the next video. Hope you try out our gear. If you already have our gear, you know, maybe this might be another idea of how you can set things up. So take care and be safe. Have a great day. Bye now. Of course, your cord comes to you already done out in a figure eight. And I like to roll it back up that way, as it makes it tangle free when you got to get it out of there. So there we go. Got a little knot in the end of there. There we go. Actually go another time here. Then I just wrap it around a few times like that. Put my thumb in there towards the end. Leaves me a place to pull my end through, pull that down, and it's good to go.